Okay, so today we're going to officially talk about the chicken door because she uses the doggy door. I got this crosshair thing on again. She uses the doggy door. You know where you have like in the door to the entrance to the house. There's like a little tiny door made for dogs or cats. Well, she uses it. Okay, but to get her to use it, you have to bend that flap up so she can get through, because she can't push through that flap all by herself. It's too heavy. But my idea was, and I think there's still time. I know it's Christmas and people might be wanting to make funny presents. Maybe do this. Make a curtain, a really pretty curtain for the doggy doors. And it could be for your dog, it can be for your hen, it can be for your cat. But yeah, so make it like a big entrance moment, with a nice finial on the curtain rod, and make the swath, and then you can even have the little ribbon there to hold it back during the day. And then you can shut it if it's too cold, take the ribbon off, and so you can get very dramatic with the velvet curtain. And I'll call it velvet. It could be velveteen, of course, or something like that. But yeah, you can be very, very dramatic. I will make one. I will make one for her, and I will attach it to the door because it is colder, if you just have it gets drafty. So, a nice thick curtain. And they're very good. Hens are very good. She will go underneath curtains, around curtains. She will go through curtains if she can. So if it just has the regular center split, she'll be able to walk in and out, or any hen or rooster. If you have a rooster, that yeah, I imagine a lot of people do put the roosters in their house because of all of the crowing outside. Yeah. And then they build, and I'm not really a fan of them, but they did build these chokers to make them quieter. Yeah, I gotta watch that. That's kind of like a cruelty to animals a little bit. They're loud though. Some of the roosters are so loud that you have to watch your hearing. But yeah, so that's an idea for any of you that sew. Make a nice little curtain, a Puppenspiel, so they can have and it also makes the house a little bit more, I don't know, give it a little luxury experience, except aside from it's just a cruddy screen door or whatever. Yeah, give it more of a luxurious experience. They really did not, and a lot of these screen doors, they did not make them nice. So it's like they do need to have like an inner curtain that fits just the screen door. And they're cold. Those screen doors are cold also. So that would be another way to, what do we call that? Weatherize your house? Yeah. I know it. Anyway, she's gotta go. I don't know. Yeah, I said. Yeah, I have to send her off to her perch. That's it. That's what I do. I put her on a perch at night. She has her perch house, and there's straw underneath, and that's that. And if something goes wrong, I can hear her. She'll say. If there's a noise outside, she'll talk about it. She's on the ball, you know. She's a pretty smart little character. And she may not be the most beautiful, but neither am I. So we match. Okay. Yeah, if we can trick these houses to be more pet luxurious, you know. So if I mean I'm not really a fan for having, you know, if I had a goat, I don't think I'd want him in the house. But I know Arnold does. Arnold does. He has his donkey in the house. And I mean, that's way cool. I mean, if he can deal with it, I just my house is too small to have a donkey, to have a goat in the house, come visit you. I mean, that's really sweet. Yeah, Arnold Schwarzenegger. He's some kind of character, isn't he? What a doll. Okay, yeah, a lover of animals, animal compassionado. Yeah, so maybe that's we can start thinking back. I went to one time. I went to it was like a real. There aren't that many actually. There's some in Manhattan, there's some in Aspen, Colorado. They're like real like snooty. Snooty stores for your pets, so you can get them the, you know, the rhinestone collars and the, you know, give them all the luxuries. And unfortunately, as silly as that is, it's been a way that does break out the third world from the possessional order of animals as theirs to eat and kill. So it does break that third world out. And so they start going, okay, I'll give my doggy rhinestone necklace. And it is a strange march into capitalism, but at least it's one that they're not eating the dogs. They're actually keeping them as pets. So yeah, so we need to do the same for these little henletas here. I'm trying to think right now because I know there's this one girl on the internet that I know from the past, and she's making like a dollhouse. And I was thinking of like a dollhouse, you know, for her nest, like a real nice little house, little castle-y house. She can go into it, and I mean, there's no reason why it can't be nice and luxurious. None whatsoever. You know? And then her little nest for eggs. As long as she has to do that, it might as well be a really tricked out scene. Yeah. You know, the glamour. Does she recognize the glamour? I don't know. I don't see why not. I don't see why not. I saw her the other day playing behind the curtains and going in and out and going, that's kind of neat. I don't see why she wouldn't recognize the difference in the material quality, just as we do. Yeah. Yeah. You know. Anyway, so let's think about that. Let's think about, I don't know, keeping up that animal. See, I don't even want to have animal pets myself. I just think we need to get rid of having animals as pets, period. But it seems like the only way to get the third world onto the wagon. So we have to keep them as pets. instead of letting them free. Oh, my dream is to just let her walk around free all day long. And I know a fox could get her, or some creature, coyote. But they do that in Hawaii, you know. Why, you know, I would just like her to have more freedom. She could run into a rooster and lay eggs wherever she wanted. Now she has to be so domesticated, you know. Like that's so great. Pretty soon, though, they'll start to say, hey, you know, she's going to have to go to college or something. Yeah. All right, enough.